You guys always ask about recommendations of good nutrition sources, so today I'm going to share 10 of my favorites. Some are YouTube channels, some are podcasts, some are Twitter accounts, so we're going to mix it up. Problem with a list like this is you always end up leaving somebody out and people get upset. So this isn't knocking anybody who isn't included. Maybe there are great sources that I'm not even familiar with. So if your favorites are not on the list, by all means, feel free to add them below in the comments. I used three criteria to put together this list. The first and the most important is that they have to be evidence-based. Doesn't necessarily mean I agree with every word the person has ever said on the internet, but these sources have a track record of quality and shooting for accuracy and of trying to stay up to date with the science. None of them are diet sources. They're all nutrition sources. Very important distinction. None of them are trying to convince you that their favorite diet is the best. They go over and they discuss the science wherever it may lead. The second criterion was that these sources have a strong focus on nutrition. There's a lot of other great channels and podcasts on science and medicine that don't particularly focus on nutrition. And that's fine too, but that's what this list is focused on. And number three, all of these sources have been around for a while and they've picked up a certain size audience and they've put together a breadth of resources. There are a lot of exciting smaller channels that are starting to pick up speed and that could very well be on a list like this a year or two from now. So that's enough blah blah blah. Let's get into it in no special order. The first resource we're going to look at is Red Pen Reviews. It's a repository of fact checks of popular nutrition books. It's run by Stefan Guyenet, who is a scientist specialized on obesity and hunger. The reviews they post grade each book on several criteria, including accuracy and healthfulness of the advice. The books they look at run the gamut from the very high level to not so scientific, but I'm always impressed by how professional and objective they are in their reviews. They don't pull punches, but they don't relish in slamming people either. Their criticism is always objective and constructive. Red Pen Reviews is just a great repository of critical and independent fact checks of books directed at the public. Second item on the list is Dr. Nicola Guess's blog. We had Dr. Guess on the channel not very long ago. She's an RD and PhD diabetes specialist at Oxford, and she covers many aspects of glucose metabolism, diabetes, and pre-diabetes in her writing. She answers a lot of common questions and debunks myths about glucose spikes, foods, and diabetes with scientific accuracy, but always keeping it simple and accessible and with some humor mixed in. I've learned a lot from her writing, and her Twitter account is great as well, by the way. Next on our list is The Drive, Dr. Peter Attia's popular podcast. Attia has an interest in nutrition, but I would actually highlight his episodes on lipids and cardiovascular disease, which are some of the highest level content on this topic you can find anywhere online. His original series a few years ago with Dr. Tom Dayspring has inspired thousands of people, myself included, to learn more about lipids and heart disease. More recently, he's had some outstanding episodes on Lp(a) and HDL lipoproteins that are just extraordinary, very thorough, very informative. Peter brings on the best of the best, and he's very good at conducting these scientific interviews. You can really sense Peter's highly analytical and rigorous mindset throughout the conversations. Next up is direct access into Dr. Tom Dayspring's mind. Well into his 70s, Tom still shares his vast knowledge of lipids and cardiovascular disease on a daily basis on Twitter with his close to 30,000 followers. Doesn't matter how much I read on this topic, I always learn something new from Tom. In a scientific field where there's so much confusion, and it's so crucial, it remains the number one cause of death, it's just an incredible privilege that we get to learn directly from someone with the experience that Tom has. And to top it off, he's very accessible. He often answers questions and shares resources and even his own illustrations. All of this completely free. You really can't go wrong by following Tom's account. Now, I will say, at first, it might seem a bit impenetrable, a bit technical, but don't stress too much. Little by little, you get the hang of it, of the terminology, and you'll be amazed by how much you learn and how much this will elevate the level of conversations you have with your doctors and your health decisions. Okay, next we have a couple YouTube channels. BioLane is hosted by Dr. Lane Norton, who has a PhD in nutritional sciences, and his content often centers on nutrition and fitness. Lane publishes a lot of fact checks of popular influencers where he mixes science with humor. Now, Lane has a very unique style that can come across sometimes as a bit aggressive, but his content is consistently evidence-based, and he will change his views and his message when exposed to evidence, which is a crucial characteristic to look for and really a mark of quality. Still on YouTube, Dr. Brad Stanfield is a New Zealand-based MD who often speaks about nutrition, supplements, and longevity. Brad's personality and his style are very different from Lane, but the commonality is that the information is rooted in evidence, not their personal preference, and also their willingness to change their views when faced with evidence. I've seen both of these guys change their positions and their messages, which really shows an effort to chase accuracy and not communicate from a place of ego, which I think is deserving of respect. Another thing I've noticed is that both Lane and Brad often talk about very popular topics where there's a lot of hype. And you learn very quickly as a YouTuber that hyping things, calling things the cure for this and the new secret and the thing nobody wants you to know and all the experts are wrong, gets you a lot of excitement and applause and faster growth. Whereas damping down on hype and talking about caution and nuance and maybe, maybe not, generally gets complaints from viewers, disappointment, and your stuff doesn't go viral. So hype is really very strongly incentivized as a creator. So finding people who are willing to go against that tide and run the risk of upsetting their own viewers when the evidence just isn't there yet is an important mark of quality. And I've seen both of these guys do it a number of times. Instead of having hundreds of thousands of subscribers, they could probably have millions if they played the game more. And I'm sure they know that. Next on the list, we have another Twitter account. Dr. Kevin Hall is a world-renowned expert in obesity and metabolism and a full-time researcher at the NIH, where he directs a laboratory. And yet, he takes out time to tweet pretty regularly to his almost 30,000 followers. He's very accessible as well, which is just an incredible opportunity to see a top scientist reasoning through evidence and common questions in nutrition. Last Twitter account on the list is Dr. Deirdre Tobias. She's an assistant professor at Harvard's Chan School of Public Health, and Deirdre is an expert in nutritional epidemiology, a field that is as complex as it is misunderstood. Deirdre regularly tweets informative and humorous threads breaking down scientific concepts and really popping the hood on how nutrition science is done, really showing us the backstage of it all. Her content is full of nuance, which is another important mark of quality, and she really stands out by how she communicates with people. Twitter can be a vicious place sometimes, but Deirdre is a total class act, always polite and patient. The last two items on the list are podcasts. The Proof is run by Simon Hill, who has a master's in human nutrition and regularly hosts conversations with leading researchers from all over the world. He has published over 200 episodes, totaling more than 30 million listens. Similar to some of the other sources, Simon is very open to ideas that don't necessarily align with his personal preferences, and he broadcasts them to his audience when the evidence justifies. Again, crucial mark of quality. Last, but definitely not least on the list, is Sigma Nutrition. Sigma is kind of a double threat. It's a podcast, but they also published detailed written articles. It's run by two scientists with a background in nutrition, Alan Flanagan and Denny Lennon. Sigma is possibly the most complete and rigorous public-facing resource on nutrition I'm aware of on the internet. They've published almost 500 episodes on every aspect of nutrition, health, and fitness you can imagine. And they've had a long list of expert researchers and clinicians on the podcast. Both the breadth and the scientific rigor make Sigma just an irreplaceable source for anybody who wants to get a little bit deeper into understanding the science of nutrition and how to apply it to daily life. So that's the list, guys. Of course, there are many other popular channels and podcasts that don't focus on nutrition specifically, like the Huberman podcast or Medlife Crisis and many, many others. So if there's interest, maybe we can make a list about medicine and science in general. Let me know below which of the items on the list, or maybe some others that I didn't include, are your go-to sources for nutrition information. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys next week. Bye-bye.